In this video, we're looking at the indefinite integral of x to the fifth times the square root of 2 minus x cubed. And this integral is in a class of integrals that I would consider to be somewhat contrived. They require an explicit u-substitution, but they also require a coincidence. So things work out really conveniently without really being able to see in advance that it's going to work out conveniently. So when you see an integral like this, it's just the first thing you try is to say, let u be the interior of the square root. And of course, we have to transform the differential here. So we're going to look at how the differentials compare. Du is negative 3x squared dx. And so what I'm going to do as a first step in transforming this integral is I'm going to start building this differential, negative 3x squared dx, up here in the integrand. And I'm going to do that by splitting off a factor of x cubed. That leaves me with an x squared. And I'm going to go ahead and tack on a negative 3 to that. So I have negative 3x squared. And I compensate out in front with a negative 1/3. And then I have the square root of u and a dx. Now the point of this, again, splitting off an x squared and tacking on a negative 3, is that when I put that together with dx, that is du. So that's taken care of. And now here's the coincidence. In other words, the thing that makes this really a contrived sort of integral problem. I end up with an x cubed left over in the integrand. And it's not hard to write x cubed in terms of u. I can say that x cubed is 2 minus u. So this allows us to complete the transformation of the integral in terms of u. I end up with negative 1/3 integral of 2 minus u. And then I'm going to write the square root of u as a u to the 1/2. Because what I'm going for here is a bunch of powers of u in my integrand. And then the negative 3x squared and the dx, those combine to give us du. So the next thing we do is distribute. And I have the integral of 2u to the 1/2 minus u to the 3/2 du. And those powers of u integrate just using the power rule. So now I have negative 1/3. And then a 2 times u to the 3/2 divided by 3/2, which is the same as multiplying by 2/3. So there's a 2/3 u to the 3/2. And then minus u to the 5/2 divided by 5/2. So that's the same as multiplying by 2/5. And we just guessed our general antiderivative. So now we introduce a plus c to the answer. Now we're not done until this is transformed entirely in terms of x. This thing was an x integral to begin with. So if I look at my first term, that's going to be a 4/3 u to the 3/2. If I distribute the negative 1/3 to that, I get negative 4/9 u to the 3/2. But u is 2 minus x cubed. So 2 minus x cubed to the 3/2. My second term is going to be positive, and that's a 2/15 out in front when I distribute my negative 1/3. So I have plus 2/15 u to the 5/2. But u, again, is 2 minus x cubed. So 2 minus x cubed to the 5/2 and a plus c. And so I want to reiterate that this type of integral is a little bit unusual and a little bit contrived in the sense that it relies on a coincidence that you can't necessarily see coming. But it's not too hard to remember what the trick is. These always involve like a square root or a fractional power of some polynomial expression like this, like 2 minus x cubed. And you just try letting u be the interior of that thing. And then you just hope this power of x out in front is just right to give you a coincidence like this, where we got a really nice substitution in terms of u after we started to transform the integral. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.